Hey everybody, so this is 007. This is part 3 of 007, so there's actually 5 parts, but this is my first time riding the third part of 007 up here in Bass Lake. It's a techie trail, but it's actually a fun ride, though you will see I absolutely miserably fail on this. I do garbage on this trail, and you'll see soon why. It's actually pretty dusty this time of year, and as you can see, nice and techy. I like this part. It's actually fun, these chunky rocks, but very dusty, and I also forgot my goggles, so that was a stupid decision. So there are some flowy parts, but the other version of this trail is called Octopus. That's also a fun, loose trail. I think a bit easier than this one because the last part of this third section is extremely techy. And then here's a little climbing section. So yeah, it gets a little pedally in this part here. And then we got Scott. Brad, and then behind me is another really good rider named Curtis. He's a really good rider. So yeah, I'm trying to like at least keep up a little bit of confidence. And then I have to shut off the GoPro there because I'm just hiking up. Now we got over the pedally section and we get to this part right here. Yeah, so a little flat section here, but it's nice going through the pine forest up in Bass Lake. And then speed it up. It looks so cool when it's sped up. I think this is like 2 times the speed, so it looks sick. Looks like, boom, I'm flying up this. I'm an excellent climber. No, I actually cannot even go half as fast as this. I'm extremely slow on climbing, as you guys already know. So this is tiring me out. It's getting me kind of ready for what's coming up next, which is another techie section that I like totally mess up on. Then we pause here. Then we start going down again. Brad and Scott are flying ahead of me. And then like, this is a nice section. It's pretty, it's got the plants, but the thing here is the plants are encroaching on the trail. See how narrow this trail is? So my brakes are basically like touching these plants, which is kind of nerve-wracking because if you go too far one way or another, you're gonna fall. And then here's a drop, and I land in the bushes. I'm like, oh shoot! I got a Curtis expert rider behind me, and he's like, hey, are you okay? I'm like, yeah, I'm fine. It's just a stupid little mistake because the trail was so narrow. I didn't land properly. If it was wider, I probably would have been fine. But I was coming in with a lot of speed on that drop, so that wasn't too smart. So we're weaving through here. Really enjoy this section. But my confidence now after falling into a bush is like really diminishing. I'm like, oh no, I'm doing so bad. I got an expert rider behind me. I'm like, what should I do? But I would definitely do this trail again. I want to conquer it completely. It's not outside my level. It's not at all outside my level. I really do enjoy it. But it was just my first time and I totally failed at it. And I almost crash into that little tree. I slip a pedal. I'm like, oh no, what am I doing? So awkward. And then Curtis behind me, he's like, hey, you might want to switch places so you can follow me, and because you've never done this trail. I'm like, okay, yeah, you could switch. Here you go. And he passes by me. And he's just like, okay, make sure you let me know if I'm going too fast. I'm like, okay. I'm like, oh, I gotta somehow keep up with him. But he's a great guy, really nice. You're not gonna leave me too much in the dust. But without these, without my goggles, this dust that he's kicking up is like killing me. And then, yeah, a nice little rock section, I guess. And then here I kind of stopped and I let Scott go in front of me. But what I didn't know is that he broke his lever, his brake lever. So then he stops here and then that messes me up on this really steep, techy rock section with a lot of chunk. I actually was feeling good going into this part, but then I have to stop and reset and have to get all back up into my bike, back in the saddle. So yeah, and then going around here, here's the hard section. Curtis is like, hey, follow me, and I'm like, yes, I am going to follow you. This is like a waterfall type section. So he's like, go over the rock, and then a little drop off, boom, and totally fail. Right in front of Brad, Curtis, and my dad. Now we are hitting 007 2, so this is the second section. Then we're gonna go down to the first section, which is honestly my favorite. The first is my favorite because it's so fast, it's so flowy. You've seen it in my first video, it's amazing. This part, it's not steep, there's nothing too hard about it, but you're literally in some sections just riding on pure rocks, just pure rocks you're going over. And it's actually fun, because you're like, oh, work shocks, come on, work for me. But like, if you slip, you're literally gonna like break your arm or something. It's gonna hurt. And then here, right around this section is where I fell in the first video, if you remember that. I fell right there, I was like, nope, I'm not gonna do that again. I'm not gonna fall in the ditch. And then, yeah, just following Curtis, he's like, what speed do you want to go? I'm like, I don't know. I'll go as fast as I can. He's like, medium? I'm like, well, I'll go as fast as I can. He's like, medium? And I'm like, okay, yeah, medium. Fine. I don't know what that means for you. It's probably like the fastest I've ever gone is medium for you. And then, yeah, this is just an awesome section. You've seen this before. I'm flying down this. And actually, surprisingly, I don't fall. I don't fall on this section. So, yay. And then I go around here, you know. Honestly, let's just cut to the first section of 007. Okay, now we are on the first section, the first part of 007. This is the longest section. And my favorite, I think it's the most fun section of the entire 007 series of trails up in Bass Lake. So yeah, I'm just flying down this. I don't know if you can tell, this is fast for me. For others, it may not be so fast. Curtis is like a couple miles ahead of me already, but like, this is fast for me. I enjoy this trail because I can go so fast. But I'm taking far too much confidence into this trail. The problem with 007 Part 3 was that I had no confidence. Here, I have way too much confidence, and that's totally gonna mess me up. I'm like, oh, I can go as fast as I want, not remembering that this is a lot more loose and dusty than it was when I first rode it. So yeah, you'll see, it's just a total complete disaster what happens. Fast forwarding to this section of the trail, so it gets really narrow here, and oh, I kind of like slide out. This actually hurt way more than it looks, but my bike's just taking so much beating here. But this section is so fun. But then this darn rock right here just blocks my view, blocks my way to like get into this like narrow canyony section, and it totally messes me up because I'm coming in with so much speed that I can't slow down in time, and that's how I slide out. And now, after three falls, I am just completely beat up. I just want to get down. I'm feeling garbage. I thought that I could do this trail perfectly, and now I'm like, oh no. Oh, and one really funny thing is, the next day, the day after this, I actually do the 007 trail part. Actually, I did octopus, but I did octopus to 2, and here I fall again. And now I'm, I hit my butt, and I'm just, I feel like I'm dying. I'm just like, oh man, what am I doing? Do I even know how to mountain bike anymore? But anyways, so I go, I do octopus, then I do part 2, then I do part 1. Perfect. I don't fall once, I'm flying down it, I have so much confidence, and I don't bring my GoPro. I don't bring my GoPro on that run, but on the run that I probably have one of the worst rides of my life, I bring it, and yeah. So you know the rest of this trail. It was in my first video. So I'm just gonna sign you off from here as we continue down the trail. Thanks so much for watching, and I will catch you guys in the next one.